Hello, everybody, and welcome. This is Adrian. Thank you so much for joining me today. It's going to be time for some Europa Universalis IV in our Spain campaign. Okay, so we just got out of a war with the Ottomans and France and a couple other people. It was a large war, and we didn't get too much from it. But now, I think we have to possibly try something a little different. We're integrating Tunis. Tunis has a few rebels, so we're going to want to help them out with these rebels. We have a lot of troops still, believe it or not, after that war. We have about 150,000. Our force is 316. We got plenty of money, no manpower, though. And we're going to go ahead and get rid of some of these rebels here. And I think we might even have to invade this little dude here of Tuscany. Let me see. Do I have a truce with this guy? Until 1791, we have a truce. France, when is our truce up, France? We have a truce that expires with France in 1789, November. So I would love to declare war against him. We'd be fighting Mamanis, Mainz, Brandenburg, and Bohemia. Russia and Austria are my allies. They will not join. Russia's a little busy with something. Russia, I think, is actually invading Courland, so... Holy shit, look at Brandenburg. They are huge. Let me see. Actually, how strong is France and Brandenburg? Brandenburg is 226,000. France is 150,000. Okay, maybe maybe I wouldn't be able to win that, actually. I don't know. What's my force limit here? My colonial nations plus grand army, full quantity, and then for my provinces, too. We can attack the Ottomans again. When? The Ottoman truce is up in 1793. So an invasion of Tuscany actually might be good. I think I might actually invade Tuscany. So Siena does not exist. Let's see. People's state has some cores out here. Yeah, I might actually just probably conquer a lot of this territory from Tuscany here in Italy. Probably take, this is Genoa right here. This is a coastal center of trade. Tuscany wields the most power here. We have the second most power, so I'd love to get up there. Spain historically owned Milan, so going up there to Milan would be pretty cool as well. Yeah, definitely we're going to want to probably take a lot of this area here. Can I release vassals by any chance? I don't really have a lot of relationship slots. Actually, I don't really have any right now. Yeah, I don't know. Might be worth invading. I think maybe... How strong is Hungary? Hungary. 59,000. Wow. Actually, so they could be a good ally. I do need, I think, another ally somewhere. Let's see. Austria, Portugal, Russia, Tunis, Two Sicilies, Batavian Republic. Huh. Okay, so on monarch death, a noble from House Rurikovich will secede to the throne. So actually, yeah, let's go ahead and be at peace here for a little while. We do need to replenish crap tons of men. Just a lot. We need to replenish a lot. So we're going to go ahead and I think just be at peace for a while, and we will invade, I think, Tuscany next. I don't think France is going to be the target that I want to go after right now. One stability, thank you. Formalize the separation of powers? Sure. I don't think we're actually going to go for enlightened despotism, because we're going to get this revolution thing. It's actually ticking up a little bit. Brandenburg declared war on Lorraine. Does that mean... Let's see, who's the emperor? I'm assuming Austria. Austria's the emperor. Lorraine is... well, this is an inter-empire war, if I'm correct, because I think Brandenburg is still part of the empire. And yes, he is. He actually added, that's kind of curious, he actually added all of this territory to the empire. I've never actually seen the AI do that, add territory to the empire. Huh. That's kind of cool. We're generating 75 ducats a month, can you believe that? Whoa, holy crap. Well, that was convenient. you know what I should do is I should build some more ships. Let me see. Where's my fleet? Like, how big of a fleet do I have? 15 heavies, 90 lights, 47 galleys, 100 and almost 10 transports. So if I wanted more ships, I'd probably get like another 30 heavies. Probably like another 50 galleys. 20 lights, and that's it. And I'd probably build that here. Let's go and make it here in Gibraltar. Nice. let's see. Do I have any mercs? I don't think so. I think these are all fresh regulars. Well, they're not really fresh. They are under strength. I still need to replenish 36,000 men. Let's go and prepare for an invasion of Tuscany. I'll go ahead and just deploy some troops. Probably in Umbria, Urbino. Let's see, we got about 2 years for this. Okay, so we'll stack wipe those guys. All right, he's allied with Nuremberg and Venice. Okay. A 155 with a weak claim, huh? Sorry. Or Soray. 155 with a weak claim. He's a noble, so he's actually an adult. Lose 10 prestige, huh? Lose 5 prestige. A 155, that's actually pretty good. I'll go ahead and take him. Oh, it's a woman. Isabel Khan. Oh, they are a baby. Okay. We have a consort, Johanna von Habsburg, a 324. 29 years old. Not bad. Okay. What's the force limit here in 74? No, that's a little much. Okay, let's go and deploy. Let me send the Navy to Napoli. Whoa. Okay, so we have some colonies finishing up here in the New World. Let's see. Anybody disloyal? Tunis is disloyal, but he won't break free anytime soon. I don't believe so. Let's just double check if we can pay off any debt. I want to make sure the colonies don't have any debt. Louisiana. Oregon, Spanish Brazil, you have 82 ducats worth of debt. Why do you have so much debt? Tunis, no. Two Sicilies, no debt. Batavians, no debt. Portugal, no debt. Portugal's not even disloyal, good. Okay. Let's go move these guys up here. There's forts everywhere. Holy crap, level 8's everywhere. Remove these guys. We'll be fighting Venice and Tuscany. We might actually co-belligerent Venice. Let's go and check out some of these notifications up here. So this revolution, this revolution might actually fire. Yeah, progress 1 per month. We have 25 months remaining, so I have to get my prestige up, and that's probably not going to happen by the end of the year. That's interesting. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I don't really mind if a revolution fires. It's actually pretty powerful. What you could do is you can actually wait. You can actually wait for the revolution to fire, and then you can actually move your capital to the province where the revolution is fired, and you can get the revolution casus belli. It's actually very strong. Or the revolution government form. It's really, really powerful. And you also get a free casus belli on all your neighbors. Although, I believe you do become the target of a revolutionary war. You become a what they call a revolution target. So all monarchies, I believe, I'm not sure if it's republics, I believe it's all monarchies that border you. There's the truce with France, it's over, 1789. Austria's already fighting France. Really? Really? You're already fighting France? Wow, I might as well just invade France right now then. Brandenburg will join. Take capital of Paris. While Manus is down there. No, who are you allied to? Manus, Mainz, Brandenburg, and then Bohemia. Will Great Britain ally me? I don't think so. Let me see here. We're still integrating to Nis. We have to keep that up for a while. When's the integration done? 1797. So I can either invade France right now or wait to invade Tuscany in 1791. I think I will wait to invade Tuscany. I think that's what I'm going to do. Yeah. That just sounds like it'd be a better war to fight. So, Let's go and dock the fleet over here. We're just going to let all the troops replenish and just reinforce and such as they need to. Let's see, we have about 16,000 manpower we still need to get back. Any policies I can enact? You can only have 5 policies at one time? Wow, I did not know that. Let's take a look here at our colonies. 2 Sicilies wants a royal marriage. I'll go ahead and accept that. Colonial. Let's go and send some colonists here. About here and about here. And then I have, I think, 1 more colony on the way. Royal marriage with Austria. Somebody just sabotaged my diplomatic reputation. Oh shit. That's gonna slow down my integration of Tunis. I damn well hope not. Oh, thank gosh it did not. Sweet. Okay, when is this revolution gonna fire? Yeah, it might actually fire by the time the war with Tuscany breaks out. Let me see. How strong are you, Tuscany? He's got 90,000, so he's got a stack somewhere over here that I can't see. That's fair. But in that case, I might have to deploy some more troops to Lucca. 2 Sicilies will help me out. I don't actually know. Ferrara's here. Oh yeah, I'm fighting the Venetians as well. I don't think Venice is strong. No, I didn't think so. He's got a lot of development, but he's not here. He's got no allies. He's got just Tuscany, so I can co-belligerent him all I want and just fight him. 10 months. 10 months. Okay, let's actually go ahead and move. I'm going to move these troops here. This stack of troops. We're actually going to move these guys to the mainland. To the Spanish Peninsula. And I want to see if I can make this revolution fire. Glory to us. Let's see, what does this revolution do? National unrest plus 10, stability cost modifier plus 10%. So I should be seeing something pretty interesting happen. We will support the burghers. Historically, Spain, at least initially after 1792 with France, once the Revolutionary War started, Spain actually opposed the French. Later on, though, became their ally with limited constitutional reforms. And then in 1808, Napoleon Bonaparte actually invaded Spain and installed his own regime. Let's see what happens. If they rise up in Toledo, I'm gonna just let them siege down the capital, and I won't oppose them, because we get the revolutionary government. Let me see here. I'm actually really curious to see what happens. Kind of excited. I don't think I've ever used this revolution thing. I've never had a revolution fire, because I've always thought it was just not good, but it's not necessarily true. It's not really bad. Morocco has declared war on Lemson. Okay. Next month. July 1791. Revolution in Spain. Decades of feudal oppression, religious intolerance, and unjust taxation have all attributed to the revolutionary movements beginning to surface across our lands. Antonio I has desperately been seeking resolutions to the ever-increasing problems as our country finds itself on the verge of financial ruin. The population's incessant strive for liberty will probably prove too much of a challenge if not handled properly. Dire times are ahead of us. Really? Interesting. See, stability is at least 1, fewer controlled rebel provinces than 1. Overthrow the government. So what happens if they do succeed in these demands? Type of government changes to constitutional republic. Let's lose 50 prestige. Constitutional republic. That is kind of like, I guess, that'd be the United States government form. Constitutional republic. I think theirs is specifically a federal republic, but it doesn't really matter. Because we were a constitutional monarchy here. Lose 50 prestige. Rebels will never negotiate. Boost stability. Spanish revolutionaries are out to topple the regime, which they regard as corrupt and deeply unjust. They believe in their cause and are led by disillusioned burghers and military officers. So I can raise my stability all the way up. 102 of your 606. Yeah, to boost ability. So I had plus two. Okay. Well, in that case, if I mean, I wanted to go for Revolutionary Empire or Revolutionary Republic, although a Constitution Republic is not the same thing. They're not gonna. It's not gonna give me the casus belli and stuff that I want. So we're gonna go to plus one, I guess, and then we're just gonna kill these rebels, and that's it. Okay, go ahead and shift, consolidate here. Let's go ahead and get some better troops. We're gonna go ahead and get the, let's see, I want offensive pips. Mixed order infantry have the most morale. Mixed order infantry are usually, yeah, I think that's what they call grenadiers. Mixed order infantry are grenadiers. Jaegers, light infantry, Napoleonic square is the square developed by Napoleon. Let me see. These guys have the most fire. Although morale does come in handy. I do have a lot of morale. I've got 8.8 morale. 2.15 shock. 2.1 fire. I'm actually going to go ahead and go. Let's go for mixed order infantry. I want to see how that works out. We have Latin Lancers right now. For the shock, right? Latin Lancers, 6 shock. Yeah. Okay. We have no debate in the Cortez. Let's see. Trade efficiency, global trade power abroad, trade range, global tariffs. I'm going to go ahead and take the global tariffs. Allow use of the crown lands, diplomatic support, sure. Okay, that's it. Hopefully we can invade Tuscany here in just a minute. The truce is up in November, so we should prepare for the war. Spain is more stable, there is no revolution now. That's it. I think it only fires once, if I'm correct. So I can go to enlightened despotism, so we are a constitutional monarchy. Your legitimacy, monthly autonomy change, years of separatism. Now we can go to max promoted cultures, monthly autonomy change, and national manpower modifier for this despotism. So we don't need the parliament anymore. Okay, let's go ahead and transfer. Let's see, who's our best general? We have some shitty, shitty generals. I might even re-roll one. Nice, a 5-2-5. Good job. I guess he's going to go in charge of the invasion of Tuscany. 20,000 manpower or 10 prestige. Cannon fodder. Is he disloyal? Two Sicilies? No. That's fine. Let's see. Britain, you will not agree to an alliance. He doesn't trust me. Constitutional restoration. Lose two stability. Oh, because we went to enlightened despotism. Separation of power will be removed from Spain. Lose two stability. 46 noble regiments rise up in Granada. In Granada? Really? Lose two stability. Shit, I'm already at 3. Gain 50 admin, and then we go back. So we get our constitutional monarchy back now. I want enlightened despotism. Screw you, rebels! We can go ahead and give the nobility some land again. There we go. Okay, so it's going to be time for the war with Tuscany. Parma is the capital. Yep. And any allies, Venice, and yeah, there we go. Tuscany is not a great power. Okay, let's go ahead and blockade this, I suppose. Shift consolidate here, and then take capital Parma, Venice, I don't know, Austria. Wow, they enforced the null treaties on Austria with me. Wow, okay. So I'm just allied to Russia, and that's it. Russia by himself. Let's go and invade Tuscany, take capital Parma, and we're going to go ahead and co-belligerent Venice. And let's go ahead and invade here. Stack wipe. Wow. 14% upon arrival here with this force. Good job. Make sure the commander's in charge. Let's go and shift consolidate. And I'm going to blockade all of Italy, basically. Take a look here. We took a minus one. The enemy has 105% discipline, 8.2 morale, 3.4 tactics. That's actually not too bad. It's really not too bad at all, actually. It's pretty decent. I'm kind of impressed. Ming has corrupted our officials. So we need to probably siege down Genoa, Arezzo, Pisa, and Siena. Quite a bit. There's Venetian troops right there. Looks like the two Sicilies and some other people are battling over here with the Tuscan and Venetian fleets. We have a massive navy, so I really don't expect that we're going to be having too many issues with defeating their naval forces. Diplomatic insult, cast this building in Louisiana? No, we're not going to do that. Louisiana's mine, damn it. Nice. 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 Brandenburg is slandered. The names of our merchants. Those espionage tricks, man. It's bad. It's real bad. Okay, so Tuscany and Venice are basically fully blockaded. That's right. We can actually even take Rhodes from the Knights. That's cool. That's going to be awesome because they're in a personal union, so they count towards a war goal, I believe. We just took Parma. I guess we just march on Genoa. I want him to go to Modena. There we go. Stack wipe. Yes. The Venetians are moving out. I could follow them, I think. Can't I? Yeah, I can. We're going to go ahead and keep... I think we're going to keep some troops near this stack. Let's go and go to Luca real quick. Shift consolidate here. Excellent. Looks like the Batavians are sieging down Nuremberg. That works out really good. That works out in my favor. See the Venetians. So this guy, I don't want that guy to actually break that siege. We're going to go for Napoli. Let's go for Naples. Go for relieve that siege. Venetians should die. Wow, that was an instant stack wipe. Holy shit. Shift consolidate here. Oh shit, I can't get back. I can't get back, can I? Nope. Yeah, I can march through the fort back to Naples, but I can't. Okay, so I have to get to Luca. That's not good. I don't want to leave this guy by himself. Oh, actually, you know what? I don't think he can actually get here because this zone of control. He has to march through the fort, I think, to get to Genoa. So he's got to siege this down first, but that's not going to take very long. It's only level one. Let's go and detach these transports here. Just get some troops to Luca. Let's see, we have a lack of admin, don't we? It appears so. Aggressive expansion impact, colonial global settler increase. I might be able to take this one off. Is this an admin? No, this is a diplo. Okay, manpower recovery speed. I don't actually... Yeah, we have to keep that on because we do use a lot of manpower. Plantations in Great Karoo. Resettlement, huh? Forbid these actions. Yeah, let's go ahead. Go ahead and do it. It's fine. Okay, let's go ahead and... actually, we'll drop off troops in Genoa. We might have to break off that siege. Nuremberg, what's up with you? We're going to go ahead and move 100,000 troops here. Taking some pretty bad attrition. That's all right, though. Nothing crazy. And... probably did not mean to do that. I think I just lifted the siege. I think I just lost my wall breach, too, but... ah, that's all right. We took a minus... no, the enemy took a minus two. Holy crap, really? Wow, the enemy took a minus two there. Nice job. Okay, so this war is going just fine. We have a lot of war score already. I want to go occupy some of Venice if I can get to it. Ferrara, and then Treviso, and then the Venetian capital. It's only level one fort. Truce with the Ottomans is over. So I can attack them a little later if I wanted to. He's got a minus one this time. Nice. Look at that. 40,000 men killed. I lost barely anything. Can you believe that? That's excellent. Excellent, excellent work. Because I have a lot of artillery, sieging down level 8 forts actually doesn't take that long, which is nice. We're not going to tax anymore. I don't want to raise any tariffs. Let's see, I think I do want to go raise Ferrara, or I want to go siege down Ferrara. Ooh, thank you, Batavians. They've already moved into that location for me. Good stuff. I can actually attack them in Navarra. Like the Milanese Navarra, I mean. Portuguese troops have moved into Cuneo, here in Sardinia, Piedmont. Shift consolidate here. We have no manpower, so we can't reinforce this stack, so we might as well just use it to siege down stuff. Yeah, let's go here. Do I have any siege leaders? I got a couple. Let me see. I think I like the combat leader, though, in charge. Combat leader is fine. He doesn't have a trait yet. Wow, these guys are going to try and take this back? Take back Genoa without any artillery. Administrative aid, I don't need any help. I'm fine. We're fine. Nuremberg joined a trade league, damn it. No, I don't want him to go for Parma. This is, straight inventory. So he's got, a minus one, and then he's taking, well, he doesn't take a river crossing, but neither do I. Wow, we killed so many. Holy crap. I think he goes for Milan. Oh, he retreats to Wallace, probably. Ming sabotaged our military recruitment. That's unfortunate. Batavians should siege that down fairly quickly. That's going to be nice. If Portugal takes Cuneo, I can march here and I think attack them in this position. Nice. Nice. Okay, so what do I want to take? We actually already hold Siena. Well, I mean, can you give me this? Do I have to occupy it? I don't know yet. Let's go lose that Diplo. I've got 37,000 men in Napoli? Really? Let's actually go ahead and invade Rhodes then. Does he have any boats? No. We're still integrating Portugal. Or not Portugal, Tunis. That's gonna be done here in just a little bit. It's actually slowed down, I think, a little bit. Because I think someone sabotaged my reputation again. Okay, we're going to engage 8,000 with 37. I already own Malta. Let's see, these guys. Let me see here, Battle of Rhodes. Excellent. And right here, we can blockade that. Is that a level 9 or a level 8? I think it's a level 8. We got a wall breach in Ferrara. Can I march to the Romagna? I have to go all the way around. I would prefer not to do that. I think I want a little more war score. I want to siege down. I think I might want to take actually Rhodes. I think I might want that. Do I already own Cyprus? I do. I already own Cyprus. I would love Crete. Naxos. Euboea. What about Chios? Yeah, they call it Sakiz in Turkish. 50,000 there. I'm hoping he's not going to go and attack the two Sicilies to relieve that siege there. Nice. We're going to take Ferrara. Oh, no. The Batavians lifted the siege of Treviso? Damn you. Who wanted that? Wow, we don't have any war exhaustion. We've lost 218,000 men to combat, or I guess that's in total, and this is 122,000 to attrition, and we still don't have any war exhaustion. It's awesome. There's no artillery in this, is there? 13,000 artillery? Wow. That's quite a bit. Let's see, do I have a full siege bonus here? Yeah, no siege leader, but that's okay. Nice, man. Venice, come on, you gotta want to give me something. By now. Wow. Decisive victory. Treviso's a level 8. Venice is a level 1. Can't get there without the help of transports. Which is not impossible. Okay. Do I want to wait for some of these sieges? Yeah, maybe we will wait a little bit. We can wait. We can afford to wait. That's fine. Tuscany wants out. I think Venice is going to want out here pretty soon. They have 10.5 war exhaustion. Why do you have high enthusiasm? I don't understand. You should not have that high of enthusiasm, man. Okay, Venice. Yeah, Venice, give me Rhodes. Will you give me Ferrara? No, I don't think so. I don't need the money. Give me Rhodes. What about, like... Ferrara would be pretty cool. He's almost willing to give me that. I can't vassalize him, right? No. Yeah, give me Ferrara. Can you do that? Let's actually go ahead and abandon Arezzo. I don't want to siege that down. We have enough war score. So he'll give me Ferrara and Rhodes. That's perfect. Get these transports. Transfer these troops back to Italy. Excuse me. Let's go to Napoli. And then, yeah, I don't know about you, Tuscany. What do I want from you? Beats me. Can't vassalize you. You cost too much. Excuse me. What about Genoa Parma? I want Genoa for sure. Genoa Parma. Holy shit, look at that coalition. No Siena. Holy shit, that's still a lot. 55 aggressive expansion. How much development is this? It's quite a shit ton, I think. We're gonna be behind on Diplo for sure. Or on admin for sure. Tuscany, Savoy, and Venice. That's doable. You want to give me all this? 47 war score? That's it? Holy shit. Milan? I don't know if I want to pay the extra Diplo for that, though. Savoy... No, I don't want to pay the extra Diplo for that either. Give up claims in Spain, war reparations. Damn, look at that. 430 admin to core all of this. 47 aggressive expansion. We lost, he lost 400,000. Tuscany will see Genoa, Parma, Modena, Mantua, Romagna, Pisa, and Firenze to Spain. Give all claims, war reparations. Damn. That's quite a bit. So now we're going to spend... Let's go and focus on admin. Now we're going to spend all of our... Let's see. Corruption spending needs to go up. Oh, that's right. Can I get a free diplomat? That's that guy, right? There we go. Okay, and then now we're going to... Let's get rid of all this overextension, I think. We have no war exhaustion, so I can just raise the autonomy on all this and then just start coring. And that's fine. I need to own this land myself, for sure. There we go. And let's come over here, and I want to hire this improved relations guy. Okay. That's pretty damn good. Spanish Italy right there. Two Sicilies is also here. Less Grand Army or one stability that we're going to lose. We're going to go ahead and lose that stability, I think. And then Tunis is going to be ours here in just a minute. Let's go ahead and control select all of our ships. I think I actually do need to get rid of this policy. This global settler increase needs to go. All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and take a quick break here, guys. We just conquered almost all of Italy. Thank you so much for watching. As always, please make sure to like, subscribe, and comment. Maybe check out Patreon, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Thank you so much.